We are happy that each week thousands of people across St. Kitts and Nevis and in the diaspora would tune in to this very informative program. For us, it is part of the government's outreach, part of the government display of our accountability, where the leadership at the highest level of the land, joined by others, make themselves available to the residents and citizens of St. Kitts and Nevis to hear their concerns, their views, and of course to take their suggestions on board as we continue the very onerous task of building St. Kitts and Nevis as the best man in small island state in the world. This month is particularly important for us because at this time of the year, we celebrate our independence. This year, we mark our 37th anniversary of independence, and it tells us that we are nearing the age of maturity. As a small island state, St. Kitts and Nevis is holding its own. And in fact, better than holding our own, we are punching way above our weight, our size, as a small state. We are the smallest sovereign independent state in the Americas. And yet, when we are judged by independent observers without hidden political agenda, we score extremely high. Every Kittishan and Nevisian, wherever he or she is, can feel proud of what St. Kitts and Nevis has achieved over the last 37 years. When we examine the World Justice Report Rule of Law Index, St. Kitts and Nevis over the last 5 years has been among the top of the class on the majority of indicators. And in particular, for 2 years in a row, St. Kitts and Nevis was the best performing country within the OECS and ranked significantly in the top among all other countries within the Americas. Equally, when we examine the United Nations Quality of Life Index, St. Kitts and Nevis again is forging ahead in the top of the class among our peers. When we are evaluated against the ICT index governance and our participation in that regard by international observers, St. Kitts and Nevis ranks very well. Indeed, in 2016, at an international conference in Botswana, St. Kitts and Nevis stood out as the only country that would have received 2 awards representing the quality of work we were doing in the field of ICT. And we could go on, relying on various indicators of growth, relying on various indices by which we benchmark nation state to a judge we are at this point in our anniversary and our life as a modern sovereign state. In terms of per capita income, St. Kitts and Nevis is number one in the OECS. And of course, we are among the top three within the wider hemisphere, excluding, of course, the USA and Canada. This is no mean achievement. And though we quarrel at times with per capita as an indicator of success of a country, it is a well-established measure to evaluate where countries are and the ability to cater to the welfare of their citizens and residents. Also, with respect to the export of merchandise, for many years, St. Kitts and Nevis has been the larger exporter of merchandise products to the USA. And of course, this continues up to today, where St. Kitts and Nevis ranks not only the highest among countries in the OECS and Barbados, but also in the broader region. On a per capita basis, our exports are at 11,541 against Bahamas, which leads the way at 11,624 per person. So these are significant developments of which we can be proud of as we celebrate our 37th anniversary of independence, and we look forward to the next 10, 20, 30 years as a sovereign state. We are well aware, while there is a lot that has been gained over the last 37 years, we live in an uncertain world, and the coronavirus disease, COVID-19, represents a significant threat. And if we are not careful, the gains built up over the last 37 years could be lost to an invisible virus. Thankfully for us, when the virus struck, reached our shores in March, St. Kitts and Nevis was best prepared of all states within the CARICOM region to respond. To respond in a timely way, closing our borders, taking drastic measures through lockdowns to ensure that we keep the people of St. Kitts and Nevis safe. I want to record our appreciation for the work, excellent work, of our health practitioners and those involved in the NEOC that have helped us to, as it were, perform as excellently as we have done. To date, we have one of the lowest rate of infection among sovereign states the world over. As we speak, we have an R value of less than one, indicating that by and large, the transmission of the virus is on a downward trend. As we speak, St. Kitts and Nevis has no deaths on record as a result of COVID-19. This stands in stark contrast to what is happening elsewhere. Today, importantly, at an international conference organized by Concordia, I was able to tell in part a story of our own success as a people and as a nation, and how that story could help other countries, large and small, follow our pattern and be able to contain the coronavirus disease. As we speak, in England, the United Kingdom, England, Scotland, and Wales, they are now going through a second worse spike than the first one. They are now undertaking measures to lock down the cities. They are now contemplating new and more drastic measures to be taken to ensure that the virus is kept under control. If we continue on the wise path, if we continue to exercise wisdom, if we do not get anxious over the fact that by and large there is no death here on account of COVID-19, we certainly could continue to be that bright beacon of hope. And we will be in a better position when our borders eventually open to the rest of the world to protect ourselves. I therefore urge one and all to continue to, as it were, adopt, comply with the regulations, and take sensible action. Because by and large, the response to COVID-19, in large measure, the success depends on each of us playing our part. And that is, we must use common sense. The science and the advice of the health practitioners say all we can do, by and large, are some simple things. We must wear the masks in public. We must, as it were, avoid getting into congested areas. We must do all we can to boost our immune system. We must practice hand hygiene and hygiene generally. And these simple things can assist us and protect us. What has happened in the United Kingdom, in the USA, in Europe, is that by and large persons became complacent and did not heed the tried and tested advice on the science, and they are back to square one. The hosting of large party and party events has become a matter of particular concern to the general public, and we will have to revisit our approach to these events. The callous approach and the callous behavior will not help St. Kitts and Nevis to maintain the high standard of management of the COVID-19, which so far has been our good fortune. So I want to appeal to all and sundry to heed the advice of our health practitioners, to put your best foot forward, to do the right thing, difficult as it may be. Practice can lead us closer to perfection on the non-pharmaceutical mandates that we have to uphold if we are to continue to succeed. Tonight, as we look forward to the future, I am very pleased to have with me one of our sons of the soil, who is serving the government and people in Washington, D.C., as our ambassador to the Organization of American States. I welcome Dr. Hull to the program tonight, thank him for his contribution in the past, and thank him for his readiness always to assist in providing ideas, suggestions, and other tangible assistance to advance the country of St. Kitts and Nevis, which he loves with all his heart. Tonight, he will take up the challenge of giving us some tips, some advice, some ideas, and how we can make the future stronger and safer. And he will zero in, by and large, on performance management issues. What it is we expect. What it is we mean, by and large, when we speak of the country getting value for money from all of its employees within the government and all of the people within the private sector. How do we infuse the right behavior in all of those who are working and who should be contributing to nation building? I look forward to his presentation tonight and to hear the calls from our citizens and residents. We are open for the suggestion and advice, not only how we can make government more efficient, but how we can also save costs of maintaining a government in St. Kitts and Nevis. So we are looking forward to your ideas. This year, I gave the responsibility of managing the 37th anniversary celebrations to our new minister, Mrs. Akilah Byron Nisbet. It was a challenge because she was relatively new, well, very new, extremely new, to government, to be more precise. And yet I had given her this special responsibility. I want to thank her for accepting the challenge and indeed surpassing the expectation of the country in terms of her able management of this, our 37th anniversary celebrations in the context of COVID-19. All the events so far, in my own estimation, has gone very well. And I want to commend her, her team, and all who would have participated. I must publicly give special commendation to Mr. Mark Pennifeather, who was the special guest at the Prime Minister's lecture, and to thank him for the way in which he engaged the young people, the future leadership of St. Kitts and Nevis, in a serious conversation about their future and our country's future. I had special delight to participate in several of the events and to left those events with a greater sense of confidence that St. Kitts and Nevis is moving in the right direction and that the stronger and safer future will be realized in the not too distant future. So to all of my citizens and residents, to all of our patriots, I say to you that St. Kitts and Nevis needs you. Your ideas and your contribution to nation building. Thank you very much again for listening to and viewing this important program, Leadership Matters in St. Kitts and Nevis.